Okay, let's see this question. In the circuit shown below, the key is pressed at time t equal to 0. Which of the following statements are true? So we have the circuit, this is the key, we have battery, two capacitors, two resistors and a voltmeter. The voltmeter is ideal. Okay. So we have got four options and more than one option may be correct. Okay. So the first option says the voltmeter displays minus 5 volt as soon as the key is pressed and displays plus 5 volt after a long time. So at t equal to 0 and t equal to infinity, we have to see how the circuit would behave after closing the switch. So first of all, let's look at t equal to 0. So at t equal to 0, the capacitors have no charge. So they behave like a short circuit. Okay, there is no voltage across them. So I can draw the circuit for t equal to 0 as follows. So the capacitors will be replaced by a short circuited wire. Okay. So this will be my circuit. Right. This is the circuit at t equal to 0. Now, the negative terminal of the battery is over here, positive terminal of the battery is over here. So, if I call this terminal as A and this terminal as B. So, this terminal A is directly connected to positive N and the terminal B is directly connected to negative N. So, VB minus VA will be minus 5 volt because the battery has EMF 5. Correct. Okay. So, VB minus VA is minus 5 because the positive end is on the B. Okay, so yes, at t equal to 0, the voltmeter will give you reading of minus 5 volt. So this part is correct. The voltmeter displays minus 5 volt as soon as the key is pressed. Okay, now we need to see whether it displays plus 5 volt after a long time. So after a long time, the capacitor has achieved steady state. Okay, the capacitor has achieved maximum charge and there will be no current flowing through it. So we can say that we can remove these two branches like this. So this is my circuit at, you could say, t equal to infinity. So now the end B is connected to positive end of battery and A is connected to negative end. So in this case, VB minus VA will now be plus 5 volt because B is at positive end, A is at negative end. So option A will be correct. Now we need to check for option B. The voltmeter displays 0 volt at time t equal to log 2, natural log 2 seconds. So for that, we need to find the time constant of the circuit. Now, what we can do is, we can ignore the battery and just draw the resistors over here. Okay. So, we don't need this anymore, so we'll keep it aside. Okay. Now, 40 microfarad and 25 kilo ohms. 40 microfarad, 25 kilo ohms, 50 kilo ohms and 20 microfarad. 50 kilo ohms and 20 microfarad. So this branch is directly connected to battery. Okay. So this branch has a separate current, it is independent of the other branch. Similarly, the other branch is directly connected to battery, so it will have its own current. Okay, so for this branch, what is the time constant? Time constant for the upper branch is how much? It will be equal to 25 kilo ohms into 40 microfarad. So you get the time constant to be equal to 1 second. Similarly, for the lower branch, time constant of the lower branch is how much? For this branch, resistance into capacitance. So 50 kilo ohms into 20 microfarad. So again, you will obtain 1 second. So the upper branch has time period, time constant 1 second. The lower branch has time constant 1 second. Now, the voltmeter displays 0 volt at time t equal to log 2 seconds. Since time constant is 1 second, we can say that the half life is tau log 2. So tau is 1, so we get log 2 seconds. Half life means what? The current should become half of maximum value. Okay, so here they are asking at time t equal to log 2 seconds. So at log 2 seconds, we have the half life. So current will be half of maximum. Now, what is the maximum current? The current will be half of maximum. And in this case, charge will also be half of maximum. We'll solve in terms of charges. So current and charge becomes half of max value. Okay, at half life. So what is the maximum possible charge on this capacitor? EMF into capacitance, 40. Here also maximum possible charge is EMF into the capacitance. So the at this moment at t equal to log 2, the charge should be half of maximum. So if I draw my circuit again, this capacitor has a half of maximum charge. So EMF is how much? EMF is 5 volt given. Okay. So 5 times 40 microfarad. So the maximum charge for here is 200 microcoulomb. Okay. But at half life, we will have 100 microcoulomb charge plus minus. And for this capacitor, how much charge we have? Maximum charge will be 100 microcoulombs. Okay. So half of that will be 50 microcoulombs, correct? Now, let's say that this has 0 volt potential. So this will have 5 volt potential. And if I go over here, I cross this capacitor. So the potential of VB will be what? VB will now be 50 by 20. QSE voltage will be there. So 50 by 20, so we get 2.5 volt. VB will be 2.5 volt, that is half of 5 volt. What about VA? So I start from here, 5 minus 100 by 40 will be VA. So VA will be 5 minus 100 by 40. So I get 5 minus 2.5, and that is 2.5 volts. So points A and B have same voltage. So the potential difference is 0. So the voltmeter will show 0 potential difference. So yes, option B is correct. The voltmeter will display 0 volt. Okay. B is also correct. Now option C. The current in the ammeter becomes 1 by E of the initial value after 1 second. So we have already calculated that the time constant is 1 second. So after 1 second, the time, the current anyways becomes 1 by E. So option C will also be correct. The current in the ammeter becomes 0 after a long time. After a long time, the capacitors achieve steady state. So no current should flow through them. So we can just like show the circuit like this. So since the circuit is now open, the current has no path to cross. Okay. The current has no path available to go to the other side. So yes, current will be 0. So option D is also correct. All options are correct.